Why are Christians so against abortion? Loving people enough to let them decide what is best for their bodies and life is what Jesus would do.
Well, Alan, you certainly have nothing shy about you in declaring what Jesus would do. Let's put the question up there because I want to see. Sometimes people say several things. Christians are against abortion, and maybe some Christians are not. That's enough. I've seen it there now. Christians are against abortion because of their high respect for life. And I've said this on other telecasts. For myself, I cannot bring myself to vote for a political party that allows the dismemberment of an unborn child in the mother's womb. That's my conviction. That is why how many Christians feel. Now, as far as what is being loving, of course, we don't want to interfere with any other individual, but it's a very unique thing in nature, and it seems like I shouldn't have to say this, that when that child in the mother's womb, and then you go to the third trimester, when I think it's 90% of the births from even early at the end of the second trimester, early third trimester, ends in a very fruitful, productive life. So you are not only having a human being inside of it, which you have the whole time, but now you have a very viable human life. And so when that life is damaged, Christians, many Christians, most Christians, I would say, consider that very unloving. So that is why. We think that Jesus would agree with that point of view. We don't want to take it lightly to speak on behalf of Jesus, but that is my view. Thank you.
Next question is coming from Denisha. Should we take the COVID vaccine as soon as it is available or wait to see the long-term effects?
I say to you, Denisha, whatever is not of faith, don't do it. So I suppose you could take the vaccine, and if you're concerned, you say, I claim the promise that if I drink any deadly thing, it'll harm me, or you can just take it because you believe it's working. You know, I'm not going to give medical advice on that. I'm saying that let the faith in your own heart dictate that for you. And, you know, whatever is of faith, you'll have joy in your heart to do it. So talk to Jesus inside of you. He'll give you peace about what to do. Thank you.
Last question for today is coming from Denise. As Christians, shouldn't we celebrate the Jewish feasts? They are the root of faith Jesus had.
You know, it seems, Megan, today I'm a little bit in disagreement with some of the questions. I hope they don't find me cantankerous. What do you think?
You know what? Oh, well, if they do.
You look a little hesitant. Am I cantankerous?
No, no, no. Okay.
So the questioner says here that, was it the root? How was the word in the last sentence? The root of Jesus?
They are the root of the faith Jesus had.
Well, I would disagree with that. And Jesus said he came from the Father. He says that no one knows his roots with the Father. No one knows what God the Father is like except for he who was there with the Father from the beginning. Now, Jesus was born within the Jewish faith, but that's not his roots. His root is with the Father. He came to reveal God in a way that goes far beyond any of the Hebrew feasts or the Hebrew understanding. And he says concerning the prophets who we all respect and glean much from and we lift them up, but he said even they at best only saw a glimpse of God. The one who really declares God to us is Jesus Christ. And so this teaching that you probably heard people say that Jesus, you know, his roots are in Judaism. No, Jesus' roots are with the Father and he's for the whole world, but we bless the Jewish people because salvation came of the Jews. And so when it comes to the Hebrew feast, we do not celebrate them for the following reason, which is that Jesus Christ, according to the New Testament teaching, has fulfilled the Jewish feast. So for example, we don't celebrate the Passover as something that we are looking forward to that's going to happen. We celebrate the finished work of Jesus Christ because he became our Passover lamb. So that is the reason why most Christians, that there's a little segment who are trying to celebrate all those feasts, but most Christians do not because we see Jesus as the fulfillment of the feast. And we could go through all the Hebrew feasts. In fact, I have teachings on that. I've gone through all the Hebrew feasts, the major ones and the minor ones, and we've seen there in those feasts how Jesus was the fulfillment of them.